Lord, girl. Trying to show you guys what it looks like. Of course, I cannot get a good angle for myself. Bye-bye, thank you, Lord. You've gone away.
Okay, you guys, do you see? Did you see how much I had to dust off of myself?
Colin. You got all over your scarf?
Yes, I did, though. That's my granddaughter, Arabella Rose. Okay. I am going to go ahead and nip away. Turn this off because it's extremely loud. Nip away all the lifted nail. Because these are like 4.5 weeks old. Okay. Okay. So the little bit of product I got on here now, I'm going to go ahead and remove with some acetone, and I'll be right back. Okay, guys, I'm back. And I'm going to be using the transparent nails I got, 500 in a pack. They came individually packed in their numbers. They did not come in the convenient box, but that's okay. But right now I just wanted to show you what they look like. I'm jumping the gun though because I still gotta do my cuticle work, and I am not excited about it because they're so bad. But here we go. I'm gonna spray them with my alcohol. And I'm gonna grab my Born Pretty cuticle pusher. My kids are off school because of Christmas break, so you will hear them in the background. I am sorry. So, I'm going to start by pushing back my cuticles with this side. Then I'm going to use the other side to scrape it away. You know, even though this is the hand like that I work with, like the pink, I don't know. Tell me what it is for you guys. Like, my pinky nail is so hard to work on. Like, I hate working on my pinky nail. Like, it's so hard. Do you guys have the same problem? I love that little kid giggle.
sometimes I'm gonna do like this.
That's what I would be
saying. Like that. Once you get the hang of it. There you go. Bounced on my lip and went back in my mouth. Dog down.
Yeah. give you your bandana back. If you tied on me. Yes. But can I have some of these? If you give me that back, I'll tie this around your head.
Mama, did you know I was a problem since I was a fetus?
Okay, so I have gotten all the cuticle cut and all of that jazz. So I am going to take off the surface shine. On all five fingers. I'm using 180 grit just to take off that top surface shine. All dusted, ready for application. Actually, they need wiped off with some more alcohol and then dusted. I'll be right. Okay, my divas, I am back. And again, I'm using these tips. I don't know the name of them because I don't read this language. I'm not even gonna tell you what language it is because I don't know. So, I needed numbers 2, 4, 5, and 9 for my fingers. And I'm going to put them on with IBD's brush on gel resin, starting with my pinky first, a dab at the tip.
Yeah, she was singing like a rando. Yeah, she walked through the window.
Sometimes I use my pinchers if the tips of the edges of the nail do not attach properly. It will help the edges attach better. Gotta go down a little further than I'd like to with this one because of how high the arches are on the ends of my nail, and I think I put it on a bit crooked. Shoot. Maybe not. What do you think? Maybe not. Okay. Now I'm going to use my silver stork scissors to cut my desired length. I'm going to go back to my 100-180 grit, and I'm going to use the 100 grit side to file it in. But because I want a ballet shape, I am going to go ahead and cut that in a little bit more that way. Then I'm going to I'm going to blend the tip to the natural nail by filing the tip only, not my natural nail. Okay guys, looky, I've made this one a bit crooked, but when I go to lay my application, I'm going to fix it then, so I'll show you how to do that when I get to that point. Had to put my kittens on punishment. That's why I got so quiet. Not punishment, but I hate to say that because they're on vacation and they are wanting to play. But when they start arguing, You got to separate them. I'm so excited to do the artwork for these nails because this is a collaboration. I don't know what the funky fingers is for. I don't know, but yeah, collaboration with the fun, fabulous Nikki, Nailed by Nikki. Bam, bam, bam. Nailed by Nikki. And the great Pumpkin from Pumpkin's Nail Station. And we called this collaboration White Winter Nails. So I am excited to see what they come up with. Okay, actually I ain't gonna lie. I got a sneak peek of Nikki's. And they are so beautiful. Okay, there we go. They are ready for application. I will wipe them again with my 70% isopropyl alcohol. Alcohol, that is, and I will be right back with ya. Okay, guys, I'm back and I have separated these, and I just want to show you them in their purity. This is from the fabulous Becky Rose Nails. She has created this beautiful winter mix with gorgeous, huge snowflakes. And then hexagons, stars, and little tiny glitters. I also have from Glittertostrophy, it's called Millennium. We will be using this, and it has the flares, it has the miniature fine glitters, as well as the chunky hexagon glitters. It also has some of the little circles as well, with some of the confetti glitters as well. So I got those in my little triangular dishes. I'm also going to try to use Glittertostrophy's silver and gold mix, which is this, and it's raw prime, which is a bunch of silver and gold different size hexes. There's some the fine glitters. They're like hollow gold, hollow silver, and it has the confetti glitter as well. Again, we'll also be using charms and alloys in different colors from Glittertostrophy. I will be using this gorgeous silver. It is a silver snowflake, and I don't know if you guys can tell, but it is already curved for the nail shape. So that should be great. But I also have in my little triangular dish some different size colors and shaped snowflakes, as well as a pair of little mittens. What says winter more than a pair of mittens? I don't know. And snowflakes, you can't go wrong there. So we're going to put these gorgeous gems up here. We are going to uncap our acrylic. And over here, I will also be using the clear acrylic from ASP. Again, I'm using the Glam and Glitz White. It is called Lush Coconut, and it has a gorgeous sparkle. I don't know if you guys can see that, but I'm spilling it everywhere. Okay, and I'm also using the Quick Dip. I believe it's called Fresh Cotton from ASP. Alright, so I'm going to start out with some Beauty Secrets Prep Before on all of my nails first. My son has turned into the hairy thing on Star Wars.
Chewbacca.
We're having a Chewbacca contest here, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, now I'm going to go in with my Mia Secret Non-Burn Acid Free Primer. Extra Bond is what it's called. And I'm going to do my first coat of this because I like to do two coats of primer to ensure good adhesion. I don't use two coats of the bonder because or dehydrator. The reason for that is because I've already wiped my nails multiple times with the alcohol cleaning off the dust. So they're pretty dehydrated, ladies and gentlemen. Okay. Now I am going to get another paper towel for my Monoma wipe. I'm going to get my brush. Make sure that it's clean. And if you're interested, I am using, well, it is a Kalinske. I believe it is a number 10. I use it so much that it is falling apart. Okay, so I am also going to open up my ASP Intense Pink because I need to put a base down because I don't want the white on my natural nail. Plus, when I go back in to do an infill, I want to be able to have something to file down to. So I'm going to go in with a small bead of Intense Pink. For a thin layer. Hit it with some primer. Go back in with my small bead of Intense Pink at the cuticle area. Clean up any spot that goes over to the cuticle because you do not want it to touch. It is called a cuticle bead, but you don't want it on the actual cuticle. Hit it with the primer. Go in with my bead. My son is hitting my table. That's why you're wobbling, folks.
You're just immune to the smell.
Ladies, he wants to know if we get immune to the smell. Let him know down below. I'm trying to do this so that you guys can see exactly what I'm doing. Okay, so I've got my base layer down with my intense pink, and that's done. So I can cap that, and I can cap my primer and put that away because we are done with that part now. Now I'm going to go in with my ASP's, what color is it? Fresh Cotton. And I'm basically just going to use this as my color for my nails. So I don't want this coat to be very thick. This coat. I don't want this layer. Lord. I'll give you one time you can make fun. So go ahead. Do it now. You got my permission. I'm going to walk it down my nail, making sure that I've got my edges covered on both sides.
I'm sorry to port in, but, what would you like me to set up Alana's TV and her system?
In her, in there?
In there, like, just somewhere for now, and then if you don't like it, I'll move it.
What are you gonna put it on? Oh wow, look what I did. Quick fix.
I can move the two gesso, the gesso that has two slides in it, and then I can move it over by the sauna cabinet.
Wait. I don't know about you guys, but white seems to be a completely different, like, consistency than any other color in any collection I've ever tried. Like, it's, the ratio is completely different with the white than it is any other color. I kid you not. Like, I feel like white is really hard to work with. If you guys feel me, like, let me know down below, please. Let me know it's not just me, yo. Listen to me talking like my kids. Called you guys yo. I am so sorry. Now this is the one, you guys, that I made a little bit too narrow, and I'm gonna widen it with my acrylic. As it dries, I'm gonna keep patting at it to the side. Got that on my finger a little, it's okay. And I'm gonna widen it and widen it and widen it. Okay, you guys, see how I widened it? The tip is right there, and I gave it that much more space. And I'm blending this side over so that you can't see it. Okay. So there's that. Let me make this a little bit better right here. That last part, it was like a few seconds over 15 minutes, so I hope it doesn't give me a hard time, like, really. If not, and it does give me a hard time, you guys, then I'm so sorry you missed the first three nails. But I am just sculpting the white acrylic on my nails. Hey, you guys, if any of you guys are on my Instagram, I was doing some kind of what I want to call like a little contest. If you want some free glitters, to go ahead over there before I do my design and tell me what you think I'm going to do. I can't even remember what I said on there, but like, I wanted you to tell me how long you think I was going to go. You're kind of cheating, I guess, if you go over there now and do it. However, I did say first person to comment on the right answer wins. And what I'm going to send you is a 5 gram glitter. I don't know which glitter at this point I will be sending, but it will be a 5 gram glitter, and it will be stunning. Okay, got the white laid, ladies. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is throw on some glitter. Let's see, how are we going to do this? Alright, I'm going to lay some lush coconut at the cuticle of all my nails. No, you know what? I'm a lie. I'm gonna do that last. Okay, first what I'm gonna do is get some of my clear. And I'm gonna go on into this gold one here. And I'm going to start with the gold on my pinky. And I think what I'll do is a glitter fade that I'm going to encapsulate. Hey.
Three strikes and you're out. So she got one, you got one, and I have none. Come here. Okay. Gotta toss it to somebody. Bubba. Oh, that's a strike for me. So we're all equal now. Oh, two strikes for you. Throw it to me. You have to close it. I usually just stop.
Come on.
Okay, she has.
Just me and you.
So, she didn't get three strikes yet.
You have to get three strikes to get out.
You have two already, and I have two, and you have one still.
Did you already do this?
So nobody gets it. Wait, did I get the first one? Yeah. Am I the only one that got the first white strike?
You don't got no strikes.
Oh, so funny. You did that. So nobody got it.
Hey.
One. Wait, no, wait, no, none. You have none, so you're in the lead. So you and Arabella.
You ready?
You have two strikes. Oh, you got one strike. You lost. He's the winner again. I was gonna get the winner. You're the winner again. How are you so good at this?
You gotta catch it easy.
I am catching it even. Me too. I'm like the first one up.
That was twice you did it.
One, two, three.
Hey. Okay, we are ready to cap them with the clear from ASP. And when I go to cap, that's where I'm getting my strength, my structure.
Oh, no, come on. Let's go in the dining room. Oh, you can do it backwards. Oh, you have to, like, do this. You're doing it the wrong way. This is how you do it. This is how you jump.
One ball method. Looks good from the side view, top view. Le bubu, I got it. Le bubu from the drill. Don't ask, and I won't tell.
What she does. But you jump over it, now chat. What are you doing?
No, I'm doing it.
No.
What the heck is that thing?
Jump. Okay, divas, I'm back. I have capped all of my nails, and I am going to start filing them now.
Okay, divas, I am back and I have finished filing and I am ready to add the snowflake to my thumbnail with some bling gel. And this is what I'm using right now, but it is almost gone. I am reviewing this new top coat. Where is it? What did I do with it? 1 second, I'll be right back. Okay, I have found the top coat that I want to review. It's right here. Like I said, it has beautiful packaging. UV gel top coat. So it says that it has to be cured for... does not say. So we are going to cure it for 2 minutes because that's what I think. But what I'm going to start off by doing, this is how I get my big stuff to stick. So I get my bling gel and I get a nice little healthy amount depending on, you know, what I'm putting on. And I'm going to put that right here. So I'm going to put the majority of it there. I'm going to cover the nail with it because I'm going to put some stones as well. But the majority of it is all bunched up right there. And then on top of my bling gel, I am going to float this top coat over it. Because this will make sure that I don't have a sticky layer. I am going to pick up the snowflake with my tweezers and place it at the top of my nail. Position it where I choose to see fit. I'll grab my stones and be right back. Okay, I've got my stones, my Swarovskis. And I've also got my wax pencil to pick up my stones. I'm actually going to pour some out onto the lid so that it's easier for me to grab the ones that I want. So I've got my snowflake up here. And I'm going to take and come on around this side. With some stones. And with the gel, I can move them and position them any way I see fit. Hey, my nail divas, this is my set. What do you think? How do you think I did? What do you think of the design? Thanks for watching. Please hit the subscribe, like this video. Tell me what you think below. Share me around. Show your friends. You can book an appointment. Yeah. See you next time. Bye.